Okay, the bandwagon.
Thank you. Thank you. Good evening and welcome. My name is Dr. Lambert. I'm the Director of Bands and Brass Studies at Southern Utah University. Tonight we host our local high school symphonic bands from Canyon View High School and Cedar High School. This has become an annual event for us, an opportunity for university students and high school students to come together and just celebrate performing great concert band literature. It's also a chance for me to reach out to some dear friends, Keith Sorensen and David Jordan, excellent band directors of our local band programs. We're so grateful to them. In fact, let's give them a round of applause, should we? David Jordan and Keith Sorensen. Thank you. And we're grateful again for this opportunity to share the stage with them. But we're going to go ahead and begin tonight's concert with Cedar High School. This is actually Kelly Rowley, who's going to be starting our concert, directing Cedar High School's symphonic band. So, all right.
Thank you. Before we play our final piece, I just wanted to thank Dr. Lambert and the SUU bands, as well as Canyon View High School, for allowing us to share the stage with you tonight. It has been over a year since this band has sat on a stage in front of a live audience, and we are just thrilled to be here. So thank you in this beautiful place. Thank you. Percussion finishes just a couple more items. I neglected to mention Mrs. Kelly Rowley, who conducted the first piece for us tonight. She has been my student teacher this semester from SUU, but I absolutely have learned probably more from her than she's learned from me, and we've had a great time working together, and the kids have loved working with her, and she's just been awesome. So out loud, I'm wishing her good luck on her career. She's gonna be a killer band director. So. Thank you.
maybe one more round of applause for Cedar High School Symphonic Band. Thank you. As Canyonview High School prepares to come to the stage and we set their ensemble up here, I just wanted to inform you of a couple of things that are coming up. Traditionally, the SUU Wind Symphony does a spring tour where they travel to some neighboring states and visit several high schools and do an outreach experience. Due to obvious restrictions and circumstances, we have actually arranged to have a virtual tour. We're actually going to be on this stage at the end of next week for a couple of days, and we're going to perform a broader performance of what we're going to be performing today about approximately 20 high schools, including Cedar and Canyonview. We're grateful that they've chosen to be able to tune in on this. But the idea is to send through a live feed our performance to about 20 high school band rooms throughout the state and neighboring states. So we're excited about that, and you're certainly welcome to tune in as well. This, I should mention, as well as other performances throughout this year and in the coming months and probably years, actually, our performances are live streamed, and you can view those through our webcast links. You can access that at our music department site. And then I believe on the left column where you have a series of options for links, the bottom tab that's listed webcast, you can find the performance tonight as well as upcoming performances. So anyway, we'd invite you to do that. As well as we have a full concert, our Wind Symphony that we'll be performing tonight actually has a full concert of its own on April 6th in this hall as well, and that will also be live streamed. Thank you.
Thank you. And thanks again to Dr. Lambert for putting this on. We've been doing this for many years. Of course, last year we got canceled, but we did it for many years before that. So it's always a great opportunity to come together and share with each other and play. And the high schools, we usually do this right before our region event. We have our region event next week, so it's a great kind of pre-region performance for us. That march was His Honor by Henry Fillmore, and next we'll play a piece called In Heaven's Air by Samuel Hazo, and then we'll finish our program with a piece called Undertow by John Mackey. And Undertow is a little bit chaotic, and I thought it was a good representation of this past year, so we thought we'd give it a whirl and try it. So In Heaven's Air and then Undertow.
Maybe one more hand for Canyon View High School Symphonic Band. I think we've demonstrated this evening why this is so exciting, to be able to pull together these great groups and to have such a fun evening of amazing music. I really do consider it a great honor to know David Jordan and Keith Sorensen, and to be friends and to work with them closely. They really are just not only great people, but terrific musicians, and clearly they're doing just some wonderful things here in our local community, so it's just really exciting to see. Once again, I want to thank you for coming tonight. We're going to go ahead and move forward with the SUU Wind Symphony. We will perform next here shortly. You can maybe stand up and stretch if you'd like. This will take maybe about five or so more minutes. Thank you. I wanted to give maybe a quick explanation. That piece, titled Short Ride in a Fast Machine, is actually a classic. It is one that draws from the tradition of minimalist music. It's actually considered post-minimalist, where it takes a pattern, a repetitive pattern, whether it be melodic or harmonic, and sends it on its way pretty consistently without change for quite a while. And then gradually it changes a little bit and a little bit more to kind of take you on sort of a quick little journey there. So anyway, that was transcribed for a band several years ago, originally written for orchestra. I hope you enjoyed that by John Adams. Now we will play a pretty special piece. Gustav Holst has written fantastic music. Perhaps, as you know, The Planets, other great works, orchestral works, actually classic band literature as well. First and Second Suite, if you're familiar with those wonderful pieces. We're going to play a piece of music that isn't played very often. It actually was discovered as composed early in the 20th century and then actually not played for several decades and then rediscovered later and now has become more and more part of the standard rep. So anyway, this is titled Hammersmith by Gustav Holst. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. I just, you know, one more little note. I was doing some investigating and learned that when Holst originally wrote this piece, he writes in a manuscript that was found later that it was intended for professionals, you know, some of the highest musicians. So I'm proud of these guys for pulling that off. That's a tough performance, and they did a great job on that. So thank you for that. It's a great piece of music. We're going to go ahead and finish the concert with this wonderful, exciting piece titled Aspen Jubilee. This is a Ron Nilsson piece that is part of a series, I think. He's written many holidays, I should say, a Sonoran Desert holiday or Rocky Point holiday, and this Aspen Jubilee, sort of picturesque, high energy, epic, kind of amazing pieces that really kind of push the envelope, I think, with performers, and this is no exception. In fact, I think this is probably my favorite of Ron Nilsson's works, titled Aspen Jubilee. I want to give just a super quick shout out to, Mr. Keith Sorensen and David Jordan. Can we have them stand and give a round of applause for their outstanding bands program? Stand up there, Dave. And Keith Sorensen, thank you. I also want to thank, there's a young lady, Anna Olson, and her army that runs this show behind the scenes. Stand up, Anna. We're grateful for her and her army. Thank you. So once again, thank you for coming. I hope you enjoy Aspen Jubilee.
Thank you. world.